What's happening, everybody? Jeff Lightsy Jr. here with the Boss Sports Networks, the Victory Formation. Be sure to hit the thumbs up button, like, share, subscribe. That's Victory Formation. You see my little logo right here up at the top. I don't know if you can see it right there. But anyway, so I'm here to talk about why the Clippers are about to lose Paul George and Kawhi Leonard, right? They have put their whole stock, they're all in on Rajon Rondo. Now, Rondo is my guy, 502 stand up. You know what I'm saying? He's from Louisville. I'm from Louisville. I'm a Rondo person. But they have just put the future of their organization in the hands of Rajon Rondo and thinking that he's going to save them, right? Because here's the thing. Paul George and Kawhi Leonard can both become free agents after the season. And as we know, last year didn't go as planned, and they had to shake everything up. They fired Doc. They got rid of some guys. They got rid of Trez. They've now gotten rid of Lou Williams. And they brought in some new guys, Luke Kennard, and they re-signed Marcus Morris. They brought in Nicholas Batum, Serge Ibaka, and now Rondo to get them over the top and to win a championship. And now the future of the organization could depend on whether Rondo can help deliver a championship, because clearly Paul George and Kawhi Leonard wasn't enough. As we saw last year, they got bounced out of the first round of, out of the second round of the playoffs, didn't even make it to the Western Conference Finals. And now this year, it wasn't looking like they were going to make it either. So that's why they had to make a shakeup. They got rid of Lou Will, sent Lemon Pepper Lou down to Atlanta, and brought in Rondo, a guy who's – I mean, Rondo's my guy, but we got to be real. He's averaging 4 points, 2 assists, 2 rebounds in only 15 minutes a game, and has missed 17 games this season. 17 games this season. Now, some people will say he was dogging it, trying to get out of Atlanta. Maybe that's true. And I'm hoping it's true, because I know Rondo's a better player than 15 minutes a game, 4 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists. I know he's a better player than that. I know he is. I saw it in the playoffs. And we know that he turns up in the playoffs. And that's what the Clippers are banking on. That's what they're hoping happens. Because if it doesn't happen, if Rondo doesn't become playoff Rondo, and they at least make it to the finals, you can see Paul George and Kawhi Leonard walk out of that door this summer. Because here's the thing. Here's what we're finding out. Here's what we didn't know before last season that we found out during that playoff series against Denver when they lost after being up 3-1. Kawhi Leonard isn't LeBron James. Kawhi Leonard isn't a Kobe Bryant. Kawhi Leonard isn't a Michael Jordan. Kawhi Leonard isn't a Magic Johnson. Kawhi Leonard isn't a Larry Bird. He's not that kind of player. We kept trying to make him that kind of player, and we found out that he's not that guy. Now, those guys are special. They're special. They're franchise changers. They're leaders in the locker room. They're leaders outside the locker room. They do everything right on the court and off the court. They literally do everything right, and they win you championships. Kawhi Leonard can be a piece to a championship puzzle. But I don't know if he's the guy he can build the puzzle around. Now, we saw he won in Toronto. But Toronto, everybody was hurt. Everybody was hurt. And on the way to the championship, everybody was hurt. You got a lucky bounce to Philadelphia, and then everybody on the Western Conference beat each other up, and the Warriors were a depleted roster. They weren't the same. They're the Warriors we're seeing now with no Klay and no Kevin Durant. That's the Warriors team Kawhi Leonard beat in the finals. We're being real. Let's be real about it. And Paul George isn't the best number two available. He's not better even before the Brooklyn guy, James Harden. He's not better than Kyrie Irving. He's not better than Anthony Davis over in L.A. Like, they've already proven that. And so now they're putting all their chips in on playoff Rondo. They're hoping that playoff Rondo can help deliver a championship, because if he can't, you might see Kawhi Leonard and Paul George, who can both opt out of their deal. Remember, Kawhi Leonard signed a 3-year deal and can opt out after 2. This is the second year. Paul George signed a 4-year deal and can opt out after 3. He did the first year in OKC. This is year 2 in Clipperland. You could lose both of them this offseason. That should be scary. And that's why the Clippers had to make a move, because the roster that was currently constructed with Lou Williams wasn't going to get it done. And now they think a guy, even though he's my guy, 502, Rondo stand up, but he's averaging, we're just being real, he's averaging 4 points, 2 rebounds, and 2 assists, can save their franchise. And if he can't, you could see your 2 best players walk out of the door this summer. And that would make this an extreme bust. You mortgage the future to go out and get Paul George, because that's what Kawhi Leonard wanted. And now you could potentially not win a championship with either during their time and lose both of them just after 3 years. You know, best of luck to you, Rondo. That's a lot of pressure. Once again, I'm Jeff Lightsy Jr. with Victory Formation and the Boss Sports Network. Be sure to hit the thumbs up button on your way out. I'll see you guys.